if you remember, we explored the surface of this rig, and now we've taken the bell, big bathysphere basically, all the way down to the facility at the bottom. And right now there is no oxygen in the said facility, so we're sending the bear.
Welcome to the Mule. You are now in the lobby.
Dock diving bells. Diving bells just ponderously out from its arrival dock. An immense mechanical foil simultaneously imprisoned in a protective cable. Juka coal machine. Juka is a tonic that can be used to alleviate a range of illnesses and neurological conditions.
Hide and seek would be the best game choice here.
No bodies. No one at all.
And it looks sealed off.
Where did everyone go? Someplace further in?
Ready to tackle the weekend. Remember, a curious mind gets results. So don't be afraid to ask questions and seek new opportunities.
Alright. So, we got discard equipment. Equipment and clutter were shown to the side. Quantity of discarded wrappers, cans, and containers suggest that this facility was once heavily populated. Now the forsaken trash only magnifies the silent hall. Broken ladder. The ladder rungs hang in half ruins, separating either from past misfortune or a deliberate attempt to prevent access to the space. Air processor infiltration. The air filtration pump is dead, its function having ceased for such a time that the atmosphere has been starved and strained from its vital life. Anybody alive down here, right? Cables, peril.
These doors are locked.
I figured. Emergency bulkheads came down.
Then people could still be alive on the other side.
Wow, okay. Never mind, what I was going to say is, parallel cabling runs from the ceiling mounted port down into the air compressor designed to transmit both power and data. The door is securely sealed.
I see we have a lot on our plate. Your debt is final to us. So let's ensure we're all working hard to meet our goals and deliver on our commitments.
This is not safe for children.
Someone wanted food bad.
The glass is too thick for a bear. It needs a Mac.
Change for creation is the journey of the self. through and back to the self. So let's focus on our personal growth and development and the company's success.
Locked.
Keep looking, Mose.
My Charlie. No, I do not like dogs, Charlie Mack.
Just push past it, it won't bite you.
I do not like dogs, Charlie.
He's terrified, Mack.
This dog is bad.
It's a toy. It doesn't get scared, not really. And through there's the only way to get us out of here.
And if he's ripped to shreds, then we're done.
You care about that thing too much.
This dog must be very hungry.
Hard to meet our goals and deliver on our commitments.
I do not like tight places, Charlie.
Sure like complaining, though, huh, Bear?
You're doing great, Mose.
Bad smells. Dead smells.
have a working handle.
That's a plus.
Hello, I am Moses.
What in hell?
Is that human?
Hello?
The fucking heart is still beating, Charlie.
Language, Mac.
Those look like flowers? Some sort of vegetative growth?
Flowers. They float, too.
Spores. There's spores coming off that thing. Moses, get away from it!
My Mac. Central atmospheric monitoring system requires recalibration.
I can read. Thanks, Bear.
Okay. Organic tent. Oh, yay. figure I can walk her at night between shifts and stuff her down my overalls if anybody gets close. Construction is commencing on the exterior framework of the new site entrance. Fibercrete fabrication takes about 2 months with the pre-built sections we have to work with. After the shell has been constructed, we can begin connecting the umbilical cord and draining seawater from the structure. Missy has outgrown her carry case. She is most definitely not a toy Pomeranian. Ever since we cut into the structure, I've been having bizarre dreams and waking up in a cold sweat with my eyes wide open. In the most recent vision, I am lying paralyzed on a stone slab. I hear a growl and a grunt to my left. Then I see a naked crying child to my right. Suddenly my legs start burning and I feel pressure on my prostate. Then I realize they're cutting me open from anus to chest. I look up and scream, but no sound comes out. Their cold eyes stare into my soul. Yeah, this is definitely getting some Eldritch-type stuff here. Prefabrication took slightly longer than expected due to unidentified electrical interference, but we've finished assembling the outer shell. The crew has dubbed it the Blister. By my estimation, we will begin draining the blister, so to speak, in early January. Several inspection drones went missing. They are not showing up on the mule roster. Zombie shark? One of Brian Henderson's lesser known monster movies. Oh, okay. A shark is brought back from the dead by waste runoff and wreaks havoc on a small seaside town. Practical effects aren't convincing, but they are fun. I've seen a shark with half its face missing, and Henderson took some creative liberties. Missy and I give it a 7 out of 10. The scrubbers have been bugging some of the welding units. I recommend they be deactivated until construction is complete. Furthermore, I would like to report that Robert Wallace has commandeered some company equipment, including UAVs and sample collectors for personal use. Hijacked drones have repeatedly buzzed our construction site at dangerous speeds. The Mule Supervisory Board occurs in Korea. Mr. Bruno Cortez suffered a minor injury today when a series of pipes burst on the blister. Violent pressure change in his suit resulted in a dual pneumothorax.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound minor. The damage to his lungs is irreparable. That is definitely not minor. A complete transplant has been scheduled and billed to his company account. Mandatory indentured debt obligation has been extended to 15 years until the principal has been paid. Well, further investigation is necessary, but the company has been indemnified as per Article 1287 of Mr. Correa's employment contract. We wish him a full recovery and prompt return to his post. I feel horrible. Missy was alone for 3 days until Wolf rescued her. It's been 2 months since the accident, and I still can't sleep. Whenever I visit the dig site, I get the feeling I'm being watched. It's mostly quiet. Some nights I can hear something moving deeper in the temple. I talked to Dr. Shaw about it. She says I'm suffering from trauma-induced hallucinations. Doctors never listen. I had strange dreams before the accident. At least I'm not alone down there. Sometimes Missy lets out a blood-curdling yelp. Reminds me of Cujo with her raised contract is almost up. After that mission, I will head back, head to the surface for some much needed R&R, and then we can begin shipping
all the way like this.
Lake isn't returning my calls, and neither is Lester. This is the second poker game they've missed. Come to think of it, Lake has a bounce in his step. I bet he's banging somebody on the mule. Me, I'm a one-lady man. That lady has four legs. That's a little weird. I yearn to have a waking dream again. It took me some convincing, but Dr. Shaw finally prescribed me a fat man. They're supposed to take the drug orally. But I've heard it can reduce realistic hallucinations from taking it auditory. So that's the road my fat man will take. What the hell? Bingo, it worked. Time slowed. The rhythmic beat took my body to a new plane of existence as I was pulled from my mortal coil. I was bloody grinning, slamming it. This time I spoke. I could understand the words of the song. And it was beautiful. Something crawled under my skin, into my heart, and behind my eyes. The church bells chimed, and Jesus rose. The quivering mass of flesh, I was not scared. And it all felt so real. We head straight for the ventilation shaft when the screaming started. And who should we find but, Vatican. He was releasing some kind of vaporized agent into the ventilation system while cackling like a deranged demon. He came at me with his fist balled up, made me unconscious with the canister he was carrying. That was the last mistake he ever made. When I came to, I saw that Misty had torn his throat out of his neck. I must have inhaled a massive dose of whatever poison he was trying to circulate around the mule, because I passed out again. When I woke up a few days later, my lower pooch had was half pitches. Okay. We're surviving on salvaged Juca paste. We have enough for a few months, or at least
Change volition is the journey of the self, through and back to the self. So let's focus on our personal growth and development and the company's success.
Something sharp could cut through the vines. If only I had claws.
Got it. 20, 54, 26.
Attention. Central atmospheric monitoring system has been calibrated. Attention.
I will leave here soon.
Good work, Mose. Cleverest bear. Meet us back at the main lobby.
I am the cleverest bear.
You're making a monster here.
Differential caused it to buckle.
Is Charlie Mack okay?
The diving bell's destroyed. There's no way back up.
Bigger issue is we're trapped, and it's flooding. What were you saying before? I'm caught beneath the surface.
Is Charlie Mack okay?
No, Moses. We're not. It's flooding in here. We need a way out.
Broken glass is dangerous, Mac.
Thank you, Moses. God damn it. The control box is shorted.
You'll have to bridge the short.
The handle won't stay down. The door won't stay open.
What are we?
You get through the door.
But...
I'll figure it out. Get through it. Go!
Mac? Moses? Mac, can you hear me? God damn it.
Charlie, are you there? Read me.
Mac, are you there?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, don't get too excited. Still flooding in here. Running out of headspace fast.
Okay. We'll figure it out. Figure it out.
Thank you. Maintenance requested.
Moses.
Hello, Mac. Your situation does not seem fun.
Well, you're not wrong. Can you open this vent? I hit the maintenance request.
My Mac. Routine maintenance is important.
Not bad, Bear.
Mac, I am glad you are not dead.
More than just a toy, isn't he?
You may have a point.
Where are you?
I think, an escape pod bay. Looks sealed, though. Give me a second here.
By water brought forth by Captain Long.
Yeah, it's the escape pods. And, big shock, they're all gone.
At least someone got out of here alive.
Wait. Pods aren't all gone. And not everyone escaped.
What do you mean? Someone's alive?
In one of the pods. They're not moving, but... I can hear them. Inside. Hello? Can you hear me? Are you hurt? Not gonna be easy. Lock will be pressurized. If you can hear me, I'm gonna try and get you out of there. Just stay calm.
Charlie, what the hell?
It's a dive suit. Looks like. Cut in half.
Yeah, so is the person inside it. Where the hell are you?
Looks like a dive suit bay. Oh god, there's another body here. Gonna keep looking. Maybe there's a way out or a way to help you.
Be careful.
What? Modern form specializes in precision maintenance and assembly, allowing free and a disused assembly arm stands projected to the side for longer waiting your project requiring its additional aid or its twin to malfunction in lights. Bright lights have left running. Bright lights have been left running to aid the equipment. Congratulations on your winning streak last night. I heard you cleaned Matthews out. Buzz for sample collector, like a hornet with forward rage. Listen up, Salt Dog. I need to borrow one of your UAVs for a couple of hours. It's the least you can do after getting my birthday. Sometimes I think about the rich person who got my left kidney. Of all my organs, he's my favorite. I've always found it funny that some wealthy people want real organs when they can grow, even print perfectly good replicas. They call themselves 100% human. What a bunch of yellow-leaf fanaticists. But who am I then? I felt like a cow or a Broadmare at times. But the pay is too good. Besides, after being genetically paired with a policyholder, you have to emulate their lifestyle to minimize the chances of rejection. Tonight I drown my sorrows in Manuka honey drizzled on garlicky, all but white truffles. At least I still have my heart. Heart replicas just aren't the same. They keep ticking even after I corpse. That's not the heart. The rover excursion to Alpha Base was a bust. A cave-in prevented additional access, so I squeezed through a fissure, passing through the equipment. Once I was out of the cave, headed for the base entrance, what could only be described as a bloated sea slug with teeth tore the drone to pieces, like a hungry man with a sous vide butter poached lobster. I ran this operation in the black. Bulk is going to go ballistic on my ass. Fuel maintenance. Hey, the scrubbers that maintain the graphene hollow domes A through E seem to be multiplying. I know they are bioengineered not to breed, but I am certain there are more of them every day. Scrubber orgy would be a thing to behold. I know some crew are fond of the blue electric light show they put on, but I suspect these critters are dangerous. I request an immediate catch of the catalog. Ain't safe. The mule is in chaos. The vet was hit by a stray bullet, completely tore off part of her head. The journey's ribs were knocked in. I saw a rover at the bulwark during my sneak peek. It may come in handy. We stopped the base kill order. Bullet simulated the bat, then killed the hardline DS-15. I cut the data tether to DC simultaneously, and he nuked the uplink. I don't know how long the ruse will last, hopefully long enough for us to get outside. We are headed back to the mule now. I would die for a dollop of almond caviar and a saltine cracker. The bill returned to schedule, but headed oceanside after only 10 minutes. I hope some of the crew escaped. The bill requires at least one occupant to ascend, and it sure as shit wasn't us in there. I mostly made it back. Robert, the scrubber is melted in soup. Al dente. I almost snarked on dive reentry, trying to get away from them. But those electro squibs caused a power surge on the moon pool's iris door. Alas, there has been no rescue. I smell the ghastly Aramaic stench of rotting onion, like a putrid lobster bisque. Okay.
Found a suit. Rear thruster looks damaged.
Warning. Suit thrusters removed. Suit thruster maintenance should only be performed by trained certified technicians.
According to who?
Looks like the igniter suffered a malfunction, judging by the flashing red air symbol.
Technological deep atmosphere environment suit. Systems check. Warning. Suit maintenance required before operation. Warning.
Uses bio lungs.
Yeah, looks like Iofix Mark 3 or 4. They're damaged though, and I think my only way out of here is fixing this thing.
You want to take a bio dais out onto the seafloor?
How hard could it be?
This woman.
Bio lungs removed. Bio lung movements should only be capable by certified technicians.
Careful with those. Carry disease just like any other organ.
I know how biotech works, Mac.
Rust got into this igniter. Twisting it just right got the thruster working.
These thrusters are modular. Just put in a new igniter and there we are.
Apparently.
Sith thrusters operating within established parameters.
I need coolant. Maybe I could find some somewhere else.
This is not a good place to play. It smells wrong. Like dead things.
Ever wonder what the point was of putting olfactory sensors on a toy?
Maybe, because it makes him more real.
You are either real, or you're not.
You're right, Mose. I'm sorry.
I am Moses.
Volunteer pods. What were they doing here?
You know the answer to that. If they were here by their own accord, they were paying off debts to Cain. If.
These suffer. It is painful.
Dead anyway. Sealed door. Sealed with alerted finality, either due to security lockdown or containment range beyond or both.
This is awful.
May their minds find the Nexus.
These are in pain.
Head moving. What the fuck? Okay, that's creepy. Lock me. Thank you.
I do not like this, Charlie Mack. Everything is slimy. This is a dangerous place.
I know, sweetheart. But I need those lungs. If you can repair them, can you try?
I am brave and strong.
This operation requires CSF spinal
You are in product storage, a restricted area.
Management.
Charlie. Hope's favorer.
Favorite what?
A shark. Hope's favorite animal.
It is lovely.
You are in Aquarium H1.
Decaying shark. The decaying corpse of a shark. It's leaking effluent, polluting the tank. The tank liquid pumps of cloudy bile. At a salmon hatchery on Twitter. worried about your family, dude. But there are other ways to help them. Talk to me. We'll figure it out together. It's easy for her to tell me to stop. Her dad is rich. Meanwhile, my family is chipping away at rocks. Mule Supervisory Board. The board has seen fit to approve your request for the specimen to be placed into your care. In light of your unique connection with the creature, however, we are aware of the unexploded spear gun shaft and request that you proceed with extreme caution. Management wants to know this species survives such. Management wants to know how this species survives such death, and you are to report your findings directly to Dr. Atwood. Dr. Blake Cabilius. Dr. Cabilius, I apologize if I interrupted you during a sensitive moment yesterday. I just wanted to tell you that I'm a huge fan of your work. The thesis on memory-coded RNA was an inspiration to me. Could you spare me a few moments of your time when you're feeling better? I'd love to show you the research I'm working on. Of course, it's nothing as revolutionary as yours. Still, there is something strange about the fauna down here. Something more that can be accounted for by the extreme conditions. Do you ever wonder what the Omega Boys are doing? Well, it's biowarfare, or something like it. I retrieved a sample from the corpse of one of the Omega Lab products before it was cremated. Do you know about the micro's behavior towards the genetic structure? I'm forwarding a copy of our report to the partial genome with the deepest admiration. Chase, I heard you were back at the aquarium. We should talk. I've kept Charles on ice, but it's still alive. And I will keep it that way until I've extracted every ounce of sweet revenge. Come on, I know you read these. I know you at least see them. Well, I found it. The microbe is in the shark, pulling apart its genetic structure and molding it back together like putty. Just like it did with those Omega corpses. This species shouldn't even exist, but she is neither dead nor alive here. The microbe must be endemic to this region. It appears to form a symbiotic relationship with other organisms in the ecosystem, so everything is a little infected. There's something else, too. Additional genomic information that TS-139 brings with it. I can't quite understand it yet, but I'm getting close. I've been testing my PS-139 extract on the deep sleepers in the adjacent lab, cut the microbe with holy dust and a little MDMA. I even pulled them out of stasis for a few minutes to get them to get as much info as possible. Moon's Pet product 645483 was particularly violent, so I gave her a little extra juice and a surprise critter cocktail. Yeah, I'm breaking the law, but I'm all in now. I've ordered six more. Hopefully, I'll get some adult products this time. Jack shared hallucinations, memories. Memories from previous PS-139 hosts. All of them connected through a neural mycelium network. Imagine if Kevin Bio, the shit. Test subjects. I need more test subjects. Lester, you old salt dog, come join me for a little holy dust tonight after your shift ends. Keep it on the down low. I'm keeping up appearances, letting them think I'm crazy. In an insane world, insane man must appear totally bonkers. I slipped a bit of my magic dust into Correa while he was recovering in the med bay. He will be my control subject. Ah, okay, so the guy that had the mold on her in. After Lester survived my experiment, I decided to try the distilled PS-139 RNA extract on myself. My personal microdosing is proving fruitful. The process induces a waking dream that can only be described as a shared neural network of images, sounds, and emotions. I've managed to limit the duration of the experience to a few seconds, and damn, it was a ride. I swear I touched God. The world melted into a Van Gogh painting, and I joined a metamorphosed reality of a million minds screaming together. Wilfred lasts an hour. He's not doing well. Request for financial compensation for private research. A copy of my result is enclosed as proof of concept. These findings are going to revolutionize the entertainment industry. I know that your hands are firmly up the ass of every drug dealer from Cape to Cairo, and it would be grand if we all could do this. Do you think I'm a fool? I know about the tumor, Cabilius. I got it out of him. The coward told me you're the reason it hasn't been removed. Why would that be? I looked up to you. Maybe I'm a fool, but only for that. Message hyper-overrated. Congratulations. Due to the sensitive and unconventional nature of the research and your blatant disregard for the procedure, it has been decided that a more experienced project lead is needed to oversee the next phase of trials. We do not recognize private research. You will turn over all relevant data to Dr. Yamada's team upon arrival. Dave Gallacher. Hand over my research? I've paid their price in my flesh and blood. Now they need to reciprocate. Starting with you, Gallacher. I'm releasing holy dust and aerosolized PS-139 into the vents so that everyone can see God. I've called up an old contact topside. They're sending a courier in a week. Looking forward to sitting on a sunny beach collecting my 20%. You are all scientists. You must understand that suffering is essential to progress.
Hope's favorite.
Damn.
Cold. It no longer breathes.
That harpoon. Be careful, Bear. It's explosive tipped.
My Mac.
Where they may thrive and reach their potential more.
Favorite is alive?
Good God!
Hope's favorite is alive.
Mose, get away from that.
Thank you.
spear tip meets explosive harpoon. And we've got something for cutting and blowing stuff up. Two of my favorite pastimes.
Old thruster was useless on the dive suit, but works just fine as an explosive timer.
Waste not, want not, Charlie.
Life, 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 life. like a weird cushion filled with gel. I kind of want to squeeze it.
Guys, heads up. I'm about to blow this lock.
Loud noises.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah! What the hell was that?
I didn't see. What happened?
It's like some kind of giant fucking insect.
Language, Mac.
It flew out of the escape pod. Ran right by me.
Would you prefer it stuck around?
Kane's Reign.
You said they were alive.
Well, I thought they were.
Did that thing burst out of her?
Or feeding on her? Or...
Someone there. Someone actually there.
Reusing all added to active channels.
They were using this body suit radio. That's what I heard.
Someone there? Or more dreams. In the haze.
Who is this? Are you part of the research team? Are you Kane?
Black. Dark. Can't see. Can't move. Explosions.
Are you hurt? Are you okay?
The haze. The pain.
He's rambling. We should try and find him.
Find him? What for? You remember the guy upstairs? All these other bodies? Who says he isn't the one running around doing it?
And if he isn't? He could help us. Maybe he knows a way out of here.
He's in the dark. I am here. And nowhere.
Yeah. I don't think he's gonna be much help.
Has it been 5 years already? I've been down here for so long that I've forgotten how the sun feels on my skin. My ocular implants are malfunctioning again. I really must stop procrastinating and get them checked out. Corporate offered to do a complete ocular transplant, but I refuse. Being blind from birth has its benefits. My visual memory is impounded by manipulation and interpretation. This is not a disability, but a blessing in the land of the deceased. Dr. Cabilia has further tuned my body to interface with the deep sleepers so I can keep them under observation 24/7. An unseen bonus is that once I'm connected to their limbic system, I can access their emotions. I find catharsis in reliving their lives. They did when they walked free among the flock. I have loved before many years ago. She always saw the best in my Diana. I keep telling telling myself not to send some of the product, but I just can't help it. I'm particularly fond of the Freedies family. Corporate acquired them 2 years ago, and they were shuffled around a lot before coming here. One moment on a trip to Mars, another Shanghai to the bottom of the ocean. My favorite is product 645583. She has magnificent emotions, so passionate and raw. Her dreams are fascinating. Appreciating her emotional range doesn't make me less culpable for her desecration, but it does make the work more enjoyable. Chocolate board. I am pleased to report that the isolation cell culture using immunofluorescence-based analytical procedures and nucleic acid determination molecular approaches have proven successful in detecting and identifying a PS139 strain in the historical family. It was mule poker night. I won big again. Perhaps my sense of loneliness. I really hope they are not letting me win. Dr. Drysdian Harris. Dr. Move, I report after your approval. Safe deposit of the three products I requested for study have been arriving. I will begin my observation postdate. I am racked with guilt. Who knows where these products were headed when they were procured? Now they linger here, eternal sleep, poked and prodded in the name of scientific progress and profit. Their autonomy was disregarded, and their rights and their bodies were violated. The other employees in the lab, under the illusion these people volunteered, their ignorance is appalling. Or they may know the truth and choose not to dwell on it. In the old days, we would have done the PS139 research off-world. But since the resurrection of the Father, who can stop us? Who will dare question the company, and by extension, the church? I overthink everything. Enough, Moon. Your guilt changes nothing. I knew she was special. When I first connected with product 645583's lucid dream, I'm going to name her Diana. The deep sleepers are kept in state, so they remain fresh and compliant. We seldom wake them unless an experiment or treatment requires it. Products are never allowed to leave, but maybe, just maybe, I have enough plot with corporate to change the policy. PS139, an ancient organism that remained dormant for a long time, owing to the cold temperatures and water pressure. Now in the warmth of the Mule lab, we are resurrecting it. Harris and his team are proceeding with human testing under the Omega base incident. Even having observed PS139's necrotic effect, the company sees dollar signs. Well, I see a dearth of humanity, but what can I do? I've made up my mind. Whatever response I get from Jokai, I'm setting these people free. Notice the Mule senior staff. Need to know only. Report to your personal EV for immediate evacuation. Base lockdown in progress. Black Ops team en route. Quarantine has been unexpectedly painful, but it provides the perfect cover to set Diana free. My personal EV is primed and ready for us. We'll be out of here in 5 minutes. Then we can start our new life together. Help! The EV jammed. Something is wrong with Diana. She has something growing inside of her. Oh, Kane. Oh. Is it okay?
gel replacement accepted. Gel operating within established parameters. Fire lungs replaced. Fire lungs operating within established parameters.
Let me see.
Boom. My security codes are printed on my arm, but I am a bear.
Security system access granted.
Charlie Mac.
Mac, look at this.
Looks like a rover. Big one.
That could be our way out of here. Where is this, Moses?
I can show you.
Transmitting target coordinates.
Okay. Yeah, so that's not far on the seabed. I can make it there.
Seems like a big risk.
Well, that's our reality right now.
Thank you for watching.